previously on Britain and Ireland's Next Top Model. The 13 girls moved into their new home. There was high drama on the photo shoot.
Wait, I'm really, really lightheaded.
Oh, my God, what's happened?
Hold on. Can we have a chair, please?
And at the elimination, MS was the first girl to leave the Top Model house.
I knew that I could do better than this. Like, I came into this thing really confident, but obviously I didn't do as well as I thought I would.
This week on Britain and Ireland's Next Top Model...
Oh, God.
No! Oh, my God!
Makeover Day brings dramatic changes.
I feel like I've got a carrot on my head.
The competition is thrown wide open.
Oh, my God! Yeah. I want to be her!
As the girls work their new looks at a sexy prison photo shoot.
I'm actually happy. Just happy tears.
Once again, the girls face the judges.
Last week, you were like a bit of a bimbo.
Show everybody that you want it, that way you won't go home.
Who will be eliminated tonight?
Is it a girl like you? Are you what I'm looking for? Is it a girl like you? Who can be the one I need? Who can be the one I choose? Are you what I'm looking for? Is it a girl like you? Who can be the one I need? Who can be the one I choose? Be the one, be the one, who can be the one I choose?
We came back to the house today. It was covered in police tape.
What is going on?
I thought maybe there's a male stripper inside dressed up as a policeman.
Get through the front door and it's all over the doors and it's just like, this is a bit weird.
What? Guys, look that.
And on the wall, there was all, like, mug shots of each of us.
Each of our pictures said something that they thought was wrong with our hair or wrong with our look and stuff.
How can you be too glamour?
On my mind, it said I look too glamour at the moment.
I felt like a porn star.
Like, maybe. Not too happy about that.
All wrong. All wrong.
Hello, girls. Style jury is out, and tomorrow your fashion fate will be decided. All rise and be ready to leave at 9:45 a.m. sharp. Love, Elle.
Yeah! Oh my God, makeovers!
We're getting our makeovers done, which is so exciting.
Bring it on.
Hey guys, makeover day. Big day for the girls.
Well, it's definitely make or break day.
There
for
you
some
go.
Girls.
Make or break day.
Can they take it?
Yeah.
Anything that we've decided to do, it's not going to kind of impair them. It's only going to kind of help them.
And I think after this transformation, they will become or look more like professional models.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Shall we rock and roll?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3. So, girls, welcome. We're here at the Daniel Galvin Salon, where the guys here have styled some of the most important people in the industry, from Kylie Minogue to Keira Knightley. And James here is going to be heading the star treatment that you guys are going to get, where today it's makeover time. I have divided you into groups.
And the very lucky girls that have Julian McDonald for the makeover are Roxanne, Madeleine, and I saved the best to last, obviously, Anne.
Oh. Okay, Ty, who have you got?
Anita. Emma G. And Risikat.
Okay, so I have some very diverse ladies here today. Letitia, Tasmin, and Lisa.
So I have Penelope, Jennifer, and Kelly. Yay, Kelly! Okay, guys, you ready? Should we get started? Yeah. Let's rock and roll!
You look extremely nervous.
Donkey. Think Uma Thurman in Pulp Fiction.
Okay.
We're thinking maybe Rosie,
Huntington White look. Could be really, really pretty, really soft, really wholesome.
They're just going to give it a trim, keep it long. Just, I like this, but that phrase, keep it long.
My hair is so important to me, and I've never had short hair. I've always had, like, long hair. So, like, if they do cut it, it's going to be such a change.
Well, listen, you have a lot of really short layers on top. What we have to do is get rid of all this on the bottom.
How much on the bottom, Whitney?
A lot on the bottom.
It's going to be different.
So my inspiration was the girl with the dragon tattoo. Very, very short, little bit of a tail. Mohawk type hair here, dark. Okay?
Bye-bye hair.
It's okay, you don't need it anyway.
I can't believe I'm getting my hair cut.
You've got a beautiful face, you can handle that.
Okay.
Okay?
I trust you. But I'm not going to cry in front of Elle, and I'm not going to cry in front of anyone here. Just need a few moments.
I'm scared. I don't know what they're going to do to me.
Out of all the girls, you are going to have the most dramatic makeover.
Oh my God.
Do you know what you're going?
No, not yet, but I'm getting really scared now.
Oh, my God.
Okay, thinking Halle Berry.
Shut up. No way.
No! Oh, my God. Are you crying? Big girls don't cry. Stop that.
Oh, I'm going to miss you guys.
Yeah, it's all right. You can always pick up another bag of it.
Okay. You want to hold my hand?
Yeah.
Oh.
Okay, don't worry.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh my God. It'll be fine.
Okay.
Okay, that's good. Hi, Lulu.
Yeah.
Oh, step one.
Woo!
I just can't believe that they've cut like this much off already. And there's still so much more to go. Oh.
Oh, Julian.
This is
all of it.
Yeah. You want the ponytail?
Go for it. We're going to keep this ponytail for you.
Actually, we should bag it up. And
this is horrible.
Let it go, darling. Yeah, no, you don't.
Hello, little guy.
Coming up.
Oh, God.
There's no turning back as the makeovers take shape.
Like I've got a carrot on my head.
And the judges push the girls to breaking point.
Oh, I've made many women cry. That's nothing new.
I'm feeling really excited. I've never had a makeover before. I can't wait to look more high fashion.
I think we're all really scared, but I think Lisa is really scared.
I think we're going to cut it all off.
Yeah. How much?
Like a pixie cut.
Oh, Whitney, really?
She's fighting back the tears at the moment.
Oh, my God. I don't know if I can carry this off. Oh, God.
It already looks so cool. You have a lot of guts.
Yeah.
For sure.
Oh, my God, how short have you gone there now? Oh, sweet God.
It's okay. You can cry.
No, no, no.
It's okay.
Such a change.
It's a big change.
Yeah. It's going to be okay, though.
It's going to be okay.
Yeah.
I promise. I promise. I think it looks beautiful.
Really?
I think it looks beautiful.
I'm such a girly girl.
Lisa's had all her hair chopped off, like a boy haircut. I personally don't like it.
This is how you should have came in a competition.
Yeah. We didn't know you had such beautiful hair.
That's what I told her.
Well, then we might have to do some revisions.
Yeah.
No?
Now they found out that I do have hair, I think they feel a bit guilty to cut it all off.
Just so you know, honey, this is your better side. Like, this is my better side.
I know it's going to be a shock because I'm going blonde.
Looks like a leopard.
Yeah.
A million and one colours in this.
What it looks like yet.
Well, you're not
going to
like this.
I'm still thinking Kellie Berry.
I don't think anyone here knows what they're doing with my hair, full stop, at all. Like, at all.
We're bleaching it.
Let's go for it.
everyone seems to have like different opinion, and I'm getting a bit frustrated because I don't want to live here without hair.
So after 3 hours, what are you going to do with our hair?
You're going to have to wait and see.
Elle and the hairdresser are having a bit of a lover's tiff.
I'll tell you what, okay. Once we've done the back,
okay, I'll shut up. Gonna
be
I'll
cold.
Go away.
You'll see.
Okay.
You'll see.
Elle doesn't want it to go shorter, but he's kind of edging for it to go up a bit more. And yeah, my friend could be going shorter as well. Eek.
So here we go then. So this is the colour you might end up. It's called Jaffa. And then the orange, Jaffa orange.
At the moment Roxy's like orange, I don't know what's going on there.
I knew this would happen to me, I knew it. I knew I'd get like some crazy hairstyle. Especially when I've got Julian, so I knew it.
Crazy hairstyle.
Jen, I think, is putting on a brave face. I think she is terrified about what's happening. Because the first thing she said was, I don't want to go short, I don't want to go dark. And she's getting both of them.
It kind of looks like diarrhea colour at the moment. Like a weird greeny brown, but I'm guessing that's not the colour it's actually going to turn out to be. At least I hope not.
It is so orange. Oh, it's fully orange.
You look amazing.
I know. I love it.
So amazing.
I feel like it looks too much like a boy, though.
I feel like I look kind of like a Native American.
Yeah. It feels really weird though because you can't see my eyebrows and I have quite expressive eyebrows, so now I just kind of look like I'm not really me in a way, but I like it.
Risikat's crying. She looks really, really upset. Because they weren't sure what to do with it, were they? And now they're just chopping it all off, like literally just hacking it. Sugar.
You could never look ugly. Never, ever, 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 ever. Never.
It's incredible. Do you like it?
I don't know.
You've made my hair ginger.
It's gonna look amazing. It's gonna look really good. It's gonna look amazing.
And it looks absolutely ridiculous.
She's not sure, you know. She's not sure.
It's not even like red ginger, it's just orange. And I'm like, I've got a carrot on my head.
She looks so beautiful. Do you like her? Put this little bit of light around there.
I love it. I love it.
Look at this face.
I'm just gonna have to suck it up and like it.
Is this too short?
No.
Halle Berry, Halle Berry, Halle Berry, Halle Berry.
You really made her cry.
Come on. Oh, I've made many women cry. That's nothing new. Come on.
Doesn't she look great? Look at her.
Oh my God, Kelly.
It's really chic. I absolutely love it.
Bridget Bardot. Do you know who Bridget Bardot is?
Oh, hello.
Oh my God.
Look at that, look at that.
Oh my God.
Look at that.
She looks like Oprah Winfrey when she had her hair cut short.
Did you just say that?
What does everybody think about Roxy's hair? Woo!
It's kind of amazing, it really is.
Oh my God, it looks so different. Oh Jesus.
You're dismissed.
Thank you so much.
I'm going to want to cry about how short my hair is. I'm happy I've still got the longest hair in the competition.
You've got £1,500 worth of hair in your head.
Listen to me.
It's not horrible, baby. It's not horrible. It's not. It's just you're not used to it. Look, it's going to look absolutely
amazing. Now we're getting the shape of the hair. She's going to be the standout girl.
It's really good. It's fresh.
Another one done. Madeline's done.
I'm so happy.
Now it's a new you. It's young. It's fresh. It's exciting. But you know, the colour will just pop under the camera.
Yeah. It all depends on how you work it. You know, this depends on you.
Oh, it's ridiculous. I can't even look myself in the mirror.
Anne's ready to leave the salon. The last one.
Ah. Britain and Ireland's next up, friends.
I'm feeling funky, I'm feeling fresh.
I'm feeling beautiful. I just look like an orangutan.
What did they do to that foxy roxy man? It's like having this on your
head. One bloody orange.
My man's like a prostitute.
What do you mean it's a prostitute? In what way? All they did, they just exaggerated the blonde and they added a little bit more extensions.
I think it looks really fake and cheap and nasty, like a wag. I look like I'm chasing footballers for a living.
Yeah. But I think all in all, most, like 90% of people are really happy.
No, my hair is gone.
I like Jen's hair. I do.
I like Jen's hair, but she hates it.
Yeah.
I think like she's gone up to her room. I hope she's not like crying about it and stuff.
I don't think Jen's got anyone else to blame. She's come across like with all the piercings and tattoos. She's come across like this, so they've given her that image. She might be unhappy with it, but she's kind of brought it on herself.
The makeovers will completely change the competition.
The one that looked ugly before looked actually rock and roll today. The one that looked beautiful looked like a boy.
Been a very bad day for me.
Girls, your makeovers have given you all a model look, but there's still one thing missing. I'm sure today will put a smile on your face. Get your skates on and have a great day.
Hi, I'm Mervyn Druin, partner in the London Centre for Cosmetic Dentistry. You've all been chosen for your natural beauty. And today I'm going to enhance that by brightening up your pearly whites. Yeah! Who would like to go first?
Me.
Come on. Wow, they are a little bit yellow, aren't they?
Well, this is a bit scary.
A little bit on the yellowish side. Mm. It's got a little bit of nicotine staining.
Just a nut bar, so sorry if it's just a nut.
Oh, wow.
Oh, wow.
Thank you so much.
Was a bit uncomfortable, so I had to stop like halfway through.
Oh my god, it looks amazing! That's fantastic!
Everyone else has got really white teeth, and I've got averagely white teeth.
Yeah, they still look white.
They look natural. I think they've got something done.
Morning on the L Mail as well, it said, you know, get your skates on, girls. On the bus, and there was like leg warmers and colourful tutus and champagne, and we were like, oh my god, we must be going to a skating disco.
I swear to god, oh my god.
I think everyone's getting on really well at the moment, which is good, and it's like everyone's just really happy because today was so chill. Maybe it's the teeth, which is helping people smile.
We can all
do you know
on.
Who's really winding me up though?
Who?
Letitia.
What? Ah, oh, my teeth. My teeth are perfectly white.
Oh, my teeth are not white enough.
Neither are mine, and I've got a blonde wig on my head.
It's like, mate, my hair was chopped off.
She's been treated like a baby for 18 years.
I don't think she's ready for it at all. Not for this competition. She's too young.
Hi, girls. I hope you had a great day. Enjoy it while it lasts, because tomorrow you'll be doing time.
That was so hard.
What did it say? Do time, is it?
Yeah, to do time, so maybe it's...
That is jail, isn't it?
Yeah.
I think I'm gonna be, like, villains.
Whatever it is, I can't wait. It's going to be the first time, I'm guessing, that we're going to be posing on our own.
So it's going to be a beauty shot.
But a new sparkling white tea. Ding, 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 ding.
Well, mine's half sparkly because I didn't finish it.
She is isolating herself a little bit because people are getting tired of her acting like a baby.
Coming up...
Oh, my God! I want to be her!
The girls go stir-crazy in the top model jail.
I'm actually happy. It's happy tears.
And the judges deliver some home truths in the elimination room.
You and Letitia, one of you will go because you look the same.
Turn up to the prison today and it was really exciting because Mollie King from the Saturdays was there.
Hi girls, I'm Mollie King.
Hi!
She's gorgeous, glamorous.
She's so cute, I love her. Oh, I'm really excited.
So today, you're going to be incarcerated in the top model prison so we can find out just who's got what it takes to become our top dog. Let me introduce you to your judge and jury.
Hi ladies, I'm Sarah Salter, Senior Marketing Manager for Casio Baby G. As a brand, we are passionate, forward-thinking, and love challenging the unconventional. Our watches are pretty and tough, exactly the look you'll need to encapsulate in this shoot.
Your photographer for the day is Joseph Sinclair, and Joseph has shot some of the biggest stars and a band you might have heard of called The Saturdays. OK, guys, it's time to get ready. Let's go!
Enjoy yourself, and if the boys don't behave, you know what you're doing.
Oh, yeah. Hey, Miss Kat. This is your photographer for the day, Joseph.
Nice to meet you.
You look amazing.
Thank you.
Just remember to use the watch as much as you can in the photograph. It's all about the watch.
Just tilt your head up a little bit for me.
That shot looks amazing, doesn't it?
They were saying, oh, great shot, oh, yeah, this looks amazing, oh, your body looks great.
She looks like quite a Rihanna.
Love that, love that, love that, love that.
Molly said she wants to have my body, you know.
Great. We got it. You're done. You looked amazing. Well done. High five.
That's fabulous. That's really strong. In some of the shots, she can really use the watch, but in others, she just seems to forget about it.
Yeah, that's good.
I think it was very kind of sexy and kind of grungy almost because we were in a jail. It was fierce and I love those kind of photo shoots. I love the kind of editorial stuff.
I think we've got it there.
You go get out the outfit
there. Tear off.
I love that.
Yeah, I love that too.
Just strut about like this every day.
I think she looks a little bit more nervous than the other girls.
Anita, remember you're meant to be really tough. And you look very scared and nervous right now.
Oh, okay. Yeah. It makes me a little bit nervous when people say that I look nervous. I'm not, so I don't know why. Maybe if I was nervous, I wouldn't look nervous. I don't know.
Good. Good. Head back a little bit more. Nice.
That's nice. Nice.
You like
yeah.
That?
Like, half the time, I don't feel like I look nervous. And I'm like, oh, really?
Okay, let's go. Good.
Penelope, maybe try brushing your hand through your hair or something, or grabbing onto your hair.
Chin up slightly. Yeah. Head back.
I love it just when her hair comes into her face. Yeah. It just looks really sexy.
She's got some striking features and she's very beautiful.
Hi.
How was it? I thought I look like a pretty girl trying to be in prison. So I don't think I'm naturally rough looking, which I'll take as a compliment, I think.
Great. Cool.
We've got some great shots,
so
yeah.
Many.
Amazing.
Oh, wow. Wow.
She's beautiful.
She's amazing. She's just tried about 10 different shots that none of the other girls thought of.
Every shot's great. Cool.
We've got major leg envy.
Thank you.
Kind of think like Grace Jones, you know, a little bit kind of like, that's it, yeah. Cool.
Her body is amazing, but it's kind of like she doesn't know yet how to sort of work with it. Do you know what I mean?
Makeovers was like fixing my eyes and she knows they're kind of watering.
Yeah.
I think a tear dropped, and then when someone was kind of makes a fuss, like, and oh, you just get really all upset then.
Maybe the nerves have just got to her a bit. Probably just a build-up.
She seems like she's been down all day.
I don't know, it's just a lot tougher than I thought it would be, and, like, I'm not going to give up or anything, and once I get on the shoot, I'll be grand, I know I will. But, I'm just going to try and use it. I don't know what I'm going to do. Like, I was raised, like, in the countryside, in the middle of nowhere. Like, at the moment, I'm just working retail, and, like, I just feel that, like, there has to be more to me, like, in life for me. This is more important to me than absolutely anything. And, like, I had to get it out of my head because there's no way I was sabotaging the photo shoot. So, literally, I just sucked it up.
Yeah, nice. Cool.
You look really tough in these shots. It's great.
Really good. Love that, love that, love that.
You look great.
You look amazing.
Thanks so much, everyone.
I love that.
I'm so happy now that I'm actually happy. Just happy tears.
It's amazing.
Your hair is amazing.
Thank you.
It looks incredible.
Thank you.
Chin up slightly.
I kind of feel like we started off really, yeah, really strong, and it's just gone downhill from there. She got it in the first shot.
With the day getting on, the brand rep has been forced to leave for a flight.
Sarah, the brand rep, has had to leave, so you've actually just got myself and Joseph.
Okay.
So
still
you've got it a bit easier, actually.
Chin up. Perfect. Love that. Her eyes are amazing in this. Yeah?
And the watch is getting more focused as well.
Perfect.
Some of these shots are amazing.
I had, like, a see-through black top on and then a pair of leather hot pants.
Oh, wow.
I wasn't wearing much on the bottom half.
Yeah, love that, love that, love that, love that. Yeah, love that, love that. Pipe it, yeah. Love that, love that, love that.
Joseph, we have so many. Oh, my God. I want to be her. When you look that good, I would buy the watch.
I'm going to get some clothes on now anyway.
Bye.
Yeah. You're asked about it so much.
You've got the hair.
Everyone keeps touching my hair.
You want to touch it? Oh my gosh, it looks so cool.
Great. Right.
So much attitude.
Good.
Oh, that's nice.
Oh yeah, we love that.
That was the only thing I would say, literally the only thing, is sometimes the watch did get forgotten.
Yeah.
Molly started touching my hair, like everyone does, but they said they got a shot. They said it was really, really good. I'm going to go and get changed.
Hello, girls. You've all had stunning transformations this week, but are you transforming into top models? Tomorrow you will meet with the judges and only 11 of you will remain in the running to become Britain and Ireland's next top model. Love, Elle.
The nominations are tomorrow.
So it's that nice time of
the best time of the week.
It's horrible, isn't it? Yeah. Like, you feel like you've just gotten through one elimination and then it's the next one again.
Thank God Tisha could be going tomorrow. She's too short, too commercial, and she's got really, really big knockers.
It's just after coming here too fast again. There's no way, like, I just don't think they're going to send me home unless Elle got word that I was crying and she might be like, oh, that's unprofessional.
I think Emma could go tomorrow. She's too pretty to be a model, but as long as it's not me, I don't really care.
It's judgment day for the wannabe models.
Good morning, ladies.
Hi. Hello there.
Welcome.
Oh, thank you.
And joining the panel this week is pop star and dancer Kimberly Wyatt.
I love this show, so make the best girl win.
Can't wait to see the girls.
I love
the girls are amazing.
She's small like me, 79.
The Britain and Ireland Next Top Model judges are from America, male supermodel and actor Tyson Beckford, fashion designer and style icon Whitney Port, And back are international British designer Julian McDonald. And leading the panel, our supermodel head judge, Elle.
Girls, welcome once again to the Elimination Room. And wow, look at those makeovers. You look fantastic. Now, you know our judges. And girls, I'm sure you'll recognize our guest judge. We have the former Pussycat Doll and star of Got to Dance, Kimberly Wyatt.
Hi.
I'm sure you want to be reminded of what you will win if you become Britain and Ireland's Next Top Model.
This year, the winner of Britain and Ireland's Next Top Model will begin her career living in style in a luxury suite in London. As well as a holiday to Dubai, courtesy of Atlantis, the palm and tour operator, Destinology. A contract with leading agency Models One. A six-page spread and the cover of Company magazine. A contract with Revlon to front their trend campaign in magazines, on TV, and in over 1,000 stores across the country. And an international campaign with Miss Selfridge, which will feature in over 250 stores.
We're going to have a look at your pictures, so let's start with Madeleine.
Practice my catwalk.
You're looking very confident. Shall we have a look at your best shot?
Wow.
I think you're a beautiful girl. I think in the shot and seeing you walk up here now, I want you just to take a deep breath and relax into it, and I think that beauty will shine even more.
I love the shot. I actually can see the confidence in you, you know, a little attitude. I'm proud of you.
Thank you.
Okay, so Letitia, should we have a look at your best shot?
I think you look extremely sexy, but in this picture it works for you. I know we've mentioned to you to tone down the sexiness, yeah, but working with that outfit, there's no really other way around it.
I want to see you looking like something different. The thing is, it gets a bit boring after a while.
You're boring.
No, I'm not boring. This is a good piece of advice.
I want to hear from Tyson.
I don't understand how beautiful gets boring. I'm never bored with beauty, so you continue to keep doing what you're doing, all right?
Coming up...
I don't want to go home.
The judges battle it out.
I don't like this girl, do you?
No, I do like her, but I don't like her as a model.
To decide who'll be leaving the competition.
So next up, we have Miss Kelly. How did you find the pressure on the first... This was like your first photo shoot alone, really, wasn't it?
Well, I just, like, got teary-eyed and I had a small bit of a cry, not, like, dramatic or anything like that. But I have to work on becoming confident,
yeah,
off-set, which is kind of funny because most girls, it's the opposite way around.
There's no point just being good on set and then falling apart afterwards. Mm. Should we have a look at this shot?
Yeah, go for it.
Wow.
I understand what you're going through and I think it's great that you could use that platform to pick you up and make you stronger. So I give you credit for that.
Once you start hiding that shell, we lose the great pictures. We lose this great woman in front of us. And then, you know, we got to send you home. But continue to keep growing.
Emma.
Do you know what I fear for you is you've got competition behind you because you and Letitia, one of you will go because you look the same.
Taz, would you like to come down? I think we should have a look at your best shot.
I really love this shot. And I have to say, even watching you walk up here, I think you have a great walk as well. I see a lot of potential in you. I love the face. I love the position of your body. I think you're selling the brand wonderfully. I think this is fantastic. It's fierce.
Thank you. You're my favorite guest judge.
Oh, really now?
Guest judge.
Next up, we have Foxy Roxy. Wow. Oh, Julian, you did the most fantastic job.
To be honest with you, Roxanne, last week I didn't even notice you. This week, wow, Roxy!
You don't really like your hair, do you?
Yeah.
It's growing on me.
When you look at that...
Can't you see?
See, that's genius.
And you look amazing as a blonde. I'd like to see how it photographs, though, so let's take a look at your best shot.
My face looks completely different.
What you're saying with your eyes is really important. It kind of just grabs that viewer.
You're unusual and you're fresh and you're new. And that is what the fashion industry needs.
Risikat, check it out.
Last week, you were like a bit of a bimbo.
You know,
and this week, But this week, you're strong, aggressive, and what you are, you're modern. You've become contemporary.
Wow.
She just parked a bike outside.
I know! You've had a major transformation. How do you feel about it?
It is quite weird feeling not having my hair there, but I'm trying to make it work for me the best way possible.
I think we should have a look at your best shot.
I know you're more of a rocker, hardcore chick than you are in this picture. I just want you to bring that.
You're corrupting my girls.
Me and her, we're on the same wavelength. She knows.
Next up, we have Penelope. I know you're a bit iffy about your hair because you feel like you look cheap or you feel that it doesn't work for you. Should we have a look at your photograph to see if your ambivalence about your hair shines through?
I really like this picture. I think it's quite effortless. It's a shame that you don't have confidence, though, because this is a competition. And when you walk up here, I want to see that you won it. And I'm not getting that vibe, which is...
I've been crying all morning, that's why. I don't want to go home.
You got to come out here and you got to walk with confidence and show everybody that you want it. That way you won't go home.
I want you to win. You know, you've got there's something about you, there's a magic in the air. And I'm sure a lot of people will watch this competition and say, oh, Penelope, come on! Come on, don't go home!
Next up, we have Lisa.
Fierce.
Oh, you don't like it.
It's just so different, like, from what I'm used to seeing, you know.
I gotta tell the truth.
Okay.
One night, well, a few nights, being a bad boy, I got locked up. All right?
You have?
Oh, stop it. You know I'm not that. I'm no angel. Anyway, so I spent a night in jail, right?
Okay.
And if I would have walked in my cell and I saw you look like that,
I know you.
I'd have been scared.
Yeah.
I love it.
I understand.
No, it's a good scared. I like it. I love it. It just, you're giving me this Catwoman, your photographer's dream.
And last up, we have Anita. But you definitely look beautiful.
My problem is the squinting of the eyes.
There's lots of faults, but you know what? Forget about the faults. You're hot.
Wow.
Eat your heart out, Penelope Cruz. I mean, goodness, you are a gorgeous girl. I don't think you've mastered it quite yet, but I see a lot of potential.
Well, that brings us to the time where the judges are going to retire. We're going to take some time to deliberate and decide who's going to be going home.
This hair is not really me, so I can't pretend to be something that I'm not. And just because my hair stands out, I'm not a massive, like, in-your-face kind of person.
It's really hard for me.
So, we're going to start with Madeleine. I think the angles of her face, her makeover, really rocked this week.
She looked fantastic in the pictures, but in reality, she looked like somebody else.
Letitia.
I mean, we obviously all love her. She's one of the prettiest girls in the bunch.
I think she's an absolute threat to the rest of the competition. When you look at her, you just see model.
Next, we have Kelly.
She is interesting, but the thing is she Chicago or Vogue?
She is Chicago the musical. She went with it.
But Elle, this is a fashion shoot.
Next, we have Tasmin.
I think that her photo was one of the weakest.
I love her in this picture. I think this is the best picture she's done so far.
I do have to agree. I think the picture is striking.
Roxanne.
Ooh,
you guys are all so crazy about her hair, but I cannot stand it.
Oh,
I think
Whitney.
I think it's awful. I think she looks like a clown. I think it's awful.
She got her hair. I agree.
So rocks.
Okay, moving along to Anne now.
Love it.
She has a very peculiar face.
She does stand apart from the rest of the competition.
But let's move along to Risikat.
I think it's the best one.
Oh,
I
really?
Love it. Oh, yeah, I love it. I think it's great.
Jennifer.
This is the worst picture of the week.
Sometimes they're not the best picture, but we love the girl and we think she's going to deliver better next week. Okay.
Miss Penelope.
Personality-wise, she's got great energy.
You don't like this girl, do you?
No, I do like her, but I don't like her as a model.
She's not trying too hard and it does draw me in. It's mysterious. It's got that Courtney Love sort of thing.
Moving along, we have Lisa.
Lisa's working this hairstyle. Her face looks beautiful. Her posing is great.
She's like giving me Zoolander. Like, everything is trying.
Emma G. Look at that butt.
Look at those lips.
Supermodel.
Look at that waist. Anita.
She walks good. The girl's got great attitude.
She really does look like a young Penelope Cruz.
Yeah.
I'd love to keep them all, but you know I can't.
Yeah.
So we're going to talk about who we think needs to go home. Well, I have 12 very beautiful makeover girls before me. But I have only 11 photographs in my hand, as you know, and these represent the girls who are still in the running to becoming Britain and Ireland's next top model. The first name I'm going to call, she also gets picture of the week, actually.
Roxy.
Roxy, we think you can do it, but you've got to prove to us you can.
Yeah.
Makeover of the week!
Emma. We really love this image. Well done.
Thank you very much.
Letitia.
Thank you.
You really listened to feedback. Well done. Lisa.
Thanks, Al.
Risikat, well done.
Thank you.
And can you come forward, please?
Thank you.
Next up, we have Anita. Little Miss Penelope Cruz.
Well done.
Miss Madeleine, your makeover's working for you. Kelly. Well done. Jennifer. You made it. This is not a great shot, but you're amazing. Will Taz and Penelope please come forward? So I have one photograph in my hand. And this is the photograph that represents the girl who's still in the running to becoming Britain and Ireland's next top model. The name of the girl I do not call must leave immediately. So, Taz, we definitely see an improvement, but you still have one of the weaker shots. And I'm worried, though, that your beautiful body and your face are not working together, and it's not going to work in the next phase of this competition. And Penelope, you have had a great makeover. You are definitely closer to being a model than you were when you first came into this competition. But it doesn't seem to me that you feel like you are. So who stays? Two beautiful girls, one space. And that goes to... Taz. Looked shocked.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.
You can go get your extensions on now.
It's just weird. It's just a bizarre shock. It's not the fact that I'm not going to be a model, it's the fact that I'm not going to be in the house, I'm not going to see the girls. And
there's a lot more to me than the model side. I think I've learned that I've got a bit more ambition than just being a pretty face. I think I do want to do more. And so there's still loads of doors that are still to be opened.
Bye, girlie!
Bye, girlie!
Next time on Britain and Ireland's Next Top Model, the girls bare their souls in front of 200 schoolchildren. They have to man up to get the shot in a race against time.
5 minutes starting now.
That's it there. That's good.
And things get personal at elimination.
That's someone you want to hang out with on a long photo shoot? Nah, not really.
Newly engaged Katie Price is off to Vegas, so could this mean wedding bells? The penultimate gossip lined up tomorrow at 9 on Sky Living HD. And if the angel is going to dig deep into his pockets, the business ideas better be good. More brave souls face the minted one as the new series continues tomorrow at 8 on Sky One HD.